Are you tired of the regular Steam layout and style and want to change it up? Today I'll show you how you can install a custom Steam skin quickly and easily. This feature is built into Steam already and only requires you to find your own skin and allow Steam to use it, so you don't need to install any other software for this to work. Firstly, you'll want to download a skin. There are a few places you can get skins. Steamskins.org is the main place I use to find and download skins, but other websites like steamcustomizer.com allow you to either create your own skin or download skins made by other people. For this video, I'll be using steamskins.org. Using the feature tab can show you the most popular skins for Steam. Today, I'll be installing the Metro skin. Once you choose a skin, you can view screenshots of how it will make your Steam app look. Down the bottom are two options for downloading the skin, one from the steamskins.org website and one from the official website of the skin. You want to download the most recently updated skin, which is usually on the official website download. But this is still worth checking, as steamskins.org may have an updated version themselves. In this case, I will download the most recent version of Metro from the metroforsteam.com website, and it will download as a zip file. If the official website for a skin is a GitHub repository, you can download the skin by clicking the green code button and choosing download as zip. To install a skin, you want to go to the folder where your Steam skins will be kept. Open File Explorer, click on this PC on the left-hand side, and choose your C drive. Then open Program Files x86, Steam, and find the folder named Skins. If you don't have this folder, then create a new folder and name it Skins. Open the Skins folder, then open the zip file we just downloaded. When opening the zip file, we should find a normal folder which has our Steam skin. We want to simply drag and drop the folder into our Skins folder, like this. This skin is now available for Steam to use. However, before we go back to Steam, open the folder which we just added to check if there are any fonts that are required to be installed on our computer before we enable the skin. If there is, open each font file and click Install. Once this is all done, we can close it and open Steam. Click Steam in the top left and click on Settings. Click on Interface on the left hand side, and under the heading to select the skin, open the drop down menu. The skin we just added should now be shown. Select the skin and click OK. Steam will now restart to allow the skin to apply. Once Steam opens back up, we will have our new skin applied. To disable or switch between skins, go back to the Settings menu, click on Interface, and choose a new skin from the drop-down menu, or choose Default Skin to go back to the normal Steam look. Steam will restart to allow this change to apply. With the Steam UI updating and changing over time, this has made some skins unable to work with the new versions of Steam. One example of this is the Pressure skin. I personally like the look of this skin, but when trying to open the library page to play a game, it fails to load. This issue is because the developers of the skin have not updated it to work with the new version of Steam. This is why it's important to make sure you have the most recent version of a skin to avoid any troubles. If you do have the most recent version and it still has issues like this, then the developer has simply not updated it for the current version of Steam, and you'll have to choose another skin, unfortunately. In 2018, Steam updated their social and friends system, including the UI, which made skins incompatible with this UI change. Many skins have updated since then. However, after switching skins as shown earlier in this video, the Steam Friends UI will still persist with the default theme. Steamskins.org published an article on how you can fix this, and seems to be the only material on how to do this that I could find. Essentially, go to your Steam shortcut on your desktop, if you don't already have one, make one, right-click it and choose Properties. In the Shortcut tab, the first field should be labeled as Target, with the location of your Steam application on your computer. This is where we want to add commands that Steam will recognize when opening the shortcut. The article gave three command suggestions to add into this Target section after the ending quotation marks. Dash no chat UI space dash no friends UI, or dash Steam OS, or dash no dash browser. The final command suggestion was the only one for me that personally allowed this to work and apply the skin to the Steam Friends UI, although as expected, it does not allow for any browser functions inside Steam to work, including the Community tab, Profile tab, and Store tab. So, unless there is another fix I am unaware of, the skin cannot be applied to the Steam Friends UI without losing some functionality to Steam. And that is everything on getting custom skins for Steam. If there's anything I missed or anything else you wish to say, leave it down in the comments. Leave a like if this video helps you out and consider subscribing to further support me. Thanks for watching.